The Israeli police, the IDF, and the Shin Bet arrested a Palestinian suspect in Ramallah over the weekend who is thought to have horrifically murdered 19-year-old Israeli Ori Ansbacher in Jerusalem on Thursday. Ansbacher was a National Service volunteer from Tekoa who worked in the Ya'elim Youth Center, but on Thursday evening she was brutally stabbed to death in Jerusalem's Ein Ya'el Forest. She was reported missing earlier in the day and was allegedly found naked with multiple stab wounds. Well, 29-year-old Arafat al-Rafaya has since been named as the suspect in connection with the murder, and the Shin Bet charged that he left Hebron, where he lives, with a knife, saw the victim in the forest, and killed her. Further details are still under wraps and a gag order is in place, however, as unsubstantiated reports and details have already been posted across the net. In fact, due to the public attention on both sides, Israeli police had to battle both Israelis and Palestinians in the case. First, Palestinian extremists rioted and tried to prevent security services from making an arrest by throwing pipe bombs, stones, and Molotov cocktails as Israeli units arrived in Ramallah. Additionally, from the other side, right-wing Israeli settlers clashed with security forces by trying to block roads in Jerusalem on Saturday while chanting, "The nation demands revenge," referring to the death penalty. Right-wing lawmakers like Justice Minister Ayelet Shaked even already called for the death penalty as well, and protests broke out across the country, including in Tel Aviv, calling for the same thing. As of now, only the demolition of al-Rafaya's home has been set, though. Meanwhile, Ansbacher's mother, Naama, eulogized her daughter as a beautiful writer and a poet, and rather than calling for the death penalty or revenge, she called on people to carry out acts of kindness and to, quote, add light to the world in Ori's memory. Multiple rallies and vigils were also held in Hebron, Tel Aviv, Tekoa, and Jerusalem.